Hi and welcome to my third video in the series about microorganisms and health, and today we're going to be looking at further immune responses. So we're going to be looking today at what happens after a phagocyte has encountered a microorganism or a pathogen, and then the steps taken by your other leukocytes in order to eradicate that infection. Now what happens after a microorganism has been ingested by a phagocyte is there's some remnants of that digested pathogen found within the phagocyte, and what happens to that is those remnants are actually the antigens that haven't been digested. And remember, the antigens are the surface proteins found on the surface of most cells, and these are the things that your white blood cells can use to determine whether something is foreign or whether it's yours. Now what happens is those antigens are then presented by the phagocyte on its surface, represented by this part of the diagram here. So this green bit represents the antigen that was on the pathogen, and then it shows that to a relevant T cell. Now T cells are what's known as lymphocytes, and they're another type of white blood cell, and they're referred to as T cytes because they're formed in the thymus. And in this case, the antigen is being shown to a CD4 T cell. CD4 simply means cluster designation 4, and it's a name that we give to a certain type of T cell. Now it's these CD4 cells that are actually the ones affected by the HIV virus, and they act very much like a general in the army, and they actually coordinate a response, so they bring in other relevant cells. Now, if you look at this section here, it says about the antigen-specific T cell receptor. Now antigens have a very, very specific shape, so an antigen on the surface of a particular bacteria will be different to the antigens on the surface of a virus, and so there are very, very specific receptors found on the surfaces of these cells, so it takes some time to locate the specific receptor and indeed the specific CD4 cell. Now once the correct CD4 T cell has been found, that then releases a series of chemicals called cytokines, and you can think of cytokines like a communication method between immune cells. And then from there, the CD4 cell brings in several different types of cells, but two main ones: T cytotoxic cells, and the name would suggest cytotoxic. Cytotoxic cells use toxins in order to break down pathogens. And also this cell here, very, very importantly, B cells. And B cells are the ones that produce the antibodies that can really clear up the infection very, very quickly. B cells get their name from the fact that they're produced in the bone marrow. Now, of course, a bit like the CD4 T cells, the CD8 cytotoxic cells and the B cells are very, very specific. So they send out very, very particular cytokines to attract the correct type of B cell and the correct type of other T cells. And that's all down to their specific shape. So for instance, different B cells will produce different shaped antibodies. And in this case, what you want is an antibody that will actually fit the original pathogen. The same is true with the CD8 cell. You want to bring in a CD8 cell that has a very, very specific shape, and therefore it can act on the pathogen. And so it's this whole process that takes some time to go from getting infected to being able to produce the correct antibodies, because you need to find the specific cells that can actually tackle the problem. So in summary, what first happens when you get infected by a pathogen within your bloodstream? Phagocytes encounter that. They break down and they digest the pathogen, but they don't break down the antigen that's found on the surface of that pathogen. And they then present that to a type of lymphocyte called a T cell. The T cells are like generals in the army, and they coordinate a response because they bring in the correct type of other white blood cells or other lymphocytes. The T cells can then bring in other types of T cells, namely cytotoxic T cells and a B cell. And it's these B cells that produce the antibodies. And in the next video, we'll be looking at going on to how antibodies work and exactly the next stages in immune responses.